Students, in this video, we are going to discuss about vegetative propagation in higher plants, right? So, firstly, let us discuss about vegetative propagation and types which are present in this vegetative propagation, fine? So, actually, firstly, what is vegetative propagation? It is a sexual reproduction process which occurs in plants in which a new plant grows from a fragment of the parent plant. So, here the new plant will grow from the parent plant. So, here parent plant is highly necessary to generate new plant, its baby plant. And that process can be done in two types. So we are going to consider this vegetative propagation into two types. They are natural vegetative propagation and another is artificial vegetative propagation. Fine. So what is natural vegetative propagation? This process will be done naturally. The new plant from the parent plant will be grown naturally, right? We are not going to involve, human beings are not going to involve in this propagation type, and the type of propagation is called as natural vegetative propagation. But coming to the case of artificial vegetative propagation, here human beings are highly required, where we are going to do some work upon that parent plant to generate new plant, right? And that is called as artificial vegetative propagation. The names itself identifies you what is meant by this natural vegetative propagation, where the process will be done naturally. Vegetative propagation process will be done naturally, where the parent plant will generate new plant naturally without involvement of human beings. But coming to the artificial propagation, this parent plant will generate new plant with the help of human beings. Here human beings are going to do some work. And what are those types of work? Let us see now. So firstly, let us see the types of natural vegetative propagation. So natural vegetative propagation. So actually, what happens in this natural vegetative propagation? I have said you that human beings will not be involved, right? So axillary bud grows into a lateral shoot and develop its own roots, right? So from the axillary bud, the lateral shoot will be developed and that shoot will also develop roots upon its own. Right. So by this, you can understand that parent plant will generate new plant naturally, where human beings are not going to involve. The parent plant will generate its own plant, new plant, right? Naturally, without involvement of any human being. And this natural vegetative propagation can be seen in leaves, stems, as well as the roots. So coming to the first one, leaves. So the best examples where you can see this natural vegetative propagation in leaves are bryophyllum and begonia. So for example, if you see here, this is a bryophyllum plant leaf, right? And you are going to consider this as a mother leaf. Why are you going to consider this as a mother leaf? Because from this mother leaf, the young bud will get generated, right? So from the parent plant, the new plant will be generated, right? So consider this as a mother leaf. We are going to see in the case of leaves. Hence, let us consider this as a mother leaf, and from this mother leaf, bud will be generated, right? So from this axillary bud, the young bud will be generated. So this is a new plant actually. Lateral shoot will be generated and then roots will also be generated. That's what I have mentioned in the definition. Axillary bud grows. So this is a bud and this bud grows into a lateral shoot. So this is a shoot region. The stems, the leaves and the branches will be considered as a lateral shoot, right? So this is a lateral shoot. And it also develops the own roots. So if you see here, the roots will also be developed. And this can be seen in the case of bryophyllum as well as the begonia. So this process of vegetative propagation will be done in the case of the leaves. So now let us see what is the type of natural vegetative propagation type which can be seen in the stems. In the case of stems, new plants arise from the nodes of the stem of the mother plant. So what did you understand by this? So actually, the stem, I can explain this natural vegetative propagation in the case of stem through three types: runners, tubers and bulbs. So firstly, let us see what is runners, such that you can understand this definition. So newly forming stem will grow horizontally on the ground are called as runners. So if you see in the case of this diagram, this is a mother plant, right? So this is considered as a mother plant. And here, this is a node. This is a node which can be seen in the mother plant. And from this node, a new runner will be developed. So this runner is also called as stolons. They are also called as stolons. So this is a type of branch which will be developed from the node of the mother plant. Listen to my sentences carefully, right? So from this node of the mother plant, the new stolon will get developed and it will move towards the soil. And once it moves towards the soil, then the shoot will be developed and the roots will also be developed. right? And now after some time we are going to cut this. We are going to cut this, and now this will become mother plant. And from this mother plant, another node will also be present. And from that node, again the runner will be developed, and again the new plant will be generated, right? So new plant arises from the nodes of the stem of the mother plant. So this is a new plant which has been arisen from the node of the stem. This is a stem of the mother plant. This is a mother plant, right? So how it can be generated? Through runners, which is also called as stolons. So this is about runners, and the best examples of runners are cyanodon and mint. In Telugu you are going to call this mint as pudina, right, etc. So coming to the tubers, these are round, swelling, thickened underground part of stem. So the best example you can take this tubers as potato. I think many of you people may learn about this in your smaller classes itself. So let us take this as a potato, and if you see in the case of potato, there will be small roots. When you purchase potatoes in the market, you can see small roots which are present upon the upon this potato, right? So even that roots will grow up to some part of its life. I mean, because by using the starch inside this potato, it will grow little part, right? But once you keep this potato in the soil, then a new plant will be generated because the roots are present on the potato, right? So now this potato which contains these roots, you are going to keep it in a soil. And now what will happen? And then the root will be developed. And once the root will be developed, immediately the shoot will also be developed. And now what will happen, you know? And within that roots itself, another potato will be developed with the help of the roots itself. And now if you cut that particular type of roots, again a new potato will be generated. Like this, many potatoes will be generated from one potato, right? Many potatoes will be generated from one potato. And if you cut this part of leaves, then this particular potato will become individual such that it can develop its root system as well as the shoot system, right? So that is called as tubers. So coming to the bulbs. So bulbs is a modified stem. It is a modified stem. Example, like if you take onion and garlic, you can take onion and garlic. So let us say this is onion, right? And from these roots, this many onions will be developed, right? And if you cut this particular type of onion, then this onion will become individual and it will become parent such that it can produce roots as well as the shoot system, right? It can develop into a new plant. So this is about the bulbs, and the best examples of the bulbs are onion and garlic. So this is about natural vegetative propagation in stem. So now let us see the natural vegetative propagation in the case of roots. So if you see in the case of roots, the root develop adventitious buds. These buds grow and form new plant under right conditions, right? Examples are like if you take radish, carrot, sweet potato. So let us consider this. This is a root, and from this root, one radish or one carrot or one sweet potato will be developed. And from another root, the same carrot will be developed, or radish or sweet potato, whatever. And here also the same will be developed. So for each root, this radish, carrot or sweet potato will be developed. Whatever you wanted to sow, that will get, the particular plant will get developed. So once if you sow one of the radish which has roots, then immediately the roots will be developed and the plant will also be developed. I mean the root system as well as the shoot system will also be developed. So the root develop adventitious buds. So this is a root and it will develop adventitious buds. I mean many roots, many buds will be formed, and through that buds, the radish or the carrot or the sweet potato will be developed, right? If you sow radish, then all radish will be developed. If you sow carrot, then all types of carrot will be developed. Or a sweet potato, the sweet potato will be developed. But it can be done under right conditions. Right conditions are nothing but you have to pour water properly and it should be exposed to sunlight properly, right? So these are nothing but the right conditions. So if you put this particular type of radish or carrot or sweet potato in the soil which has roots, then it can particularly develop the root system as well as the shoot system under right conditions. Fine. So this is about the natural vegetative propagation which can be seen in the case of leaves, stem as well as the roots. So now let us discuss about artificial propagation. This artificial propagation, as I have said you, it requires human beings' involvement. Here, as I have said you in the previous case of natural vegetative propagation, there is nothing involvement of human beings. But in the case of artificial propagation, human beings are must and should involved. They should propose some work. So what is the type of work? Let us see now. So based upon the type of work which will be done by the human beings on the artificial propagation, it can be classified into
three types: cutting, layering, and grafting. Cutting, layering, and grafting.
So the lower part
of the parent plant will lead to the cutting, and it is buried into the moist soil. So if you say this is a mother plant, consider this as a mother plant, and this mother plant you have to cut at the particular region. Let us say you are going to cut this type of stem or branch, and once you cut this, then if you place this particular region in this another pot which contains soil, then pot plantlet will be developed. Now this plantlet will get converted into the mother plant such that it can also produce different type of plantlets which belong to the same species called as roots, right? So the lower part of the mother plant will leads to cutting. So this is the lower part of the mother plant. It will leads to cutting. So this is cutting, right? With the red color one which I have indicated is called the cutting of the mother plant at the lower part. And now this lower part of the mother plant should be sowed in the other pot which contains soil. And now this should be kept under the right conditions. Right conditions are nothing but you have to add water, you have to keep it in the sunlight such that a new plantlet will be developed. And now this new plantlet will get converted into the mother plant such that another plantlet can be developed from this mother plant by cutting its particular part. Fine. And this process is called as cutting. And the best example for this cutting in the artificial propagation is rose. And coming to the second one, layering. A branch of the plant with at least one node is bent towards the ground and a part of it is covered with moist soil, leaving the tip of the branch, right? A branch of the plant. So this is a branch of a plant, and one of the branch should be bent by ourselves. You are going to involve, the human beings are going to involve. You should push this particular branch towards the soil. You should push this branch towards the soil, and once it pushed towards the soil, then immediately the root system which contains roots will be developed, and a shoot system which contains these branches, leaves, each and everything will be developed. And now this is considered as the mother plant, and a new plantlet will be developed from the mother plant through this process called as layering. So you might think that this is a process which is similar to the layering. Here the human beings should must and involve, where here the particular branch will not be developed from the node, where a branch should be kept towards the soil with the help of the work which should be done by the human beings, such that another new plantlet which contains the shoot system as well as the root system will be developed. So finally, what you understand, from the mother plant another new plantlet can be developed by the process of the layering. Fine, students. So coming to the third one, grafting. So it is a horticultural technique which is used to join parts from two or more plants so that they appear to grow as a single plant. So I'm going to explain you properly. So listen here. So this is a diagram. Let us say this is a pot which contains a plant, and this branch should be cut. This particular stem should be cut, and that region and that particular part which you have cut is called as rootstock, right? You are going to consider this plant as a rootstock. And what is scion? Scion is nothing but which you are going to keep the scion on the rootstock is called a scion. I mean, the plant which you are going to keep upon this rootstock is called as scion. So this region is called as scion, and this region is called as rootstock. So now you have to keep the scion upon the rootstock, in this way, right? And once if you keep this scion into the upon the rootstock, then what you are going to do, you are going to bind it. You are going to tie it. Okay, tightly, you are going to tie it tightly with raffia or tape, such that what will happen, then the water which will be taken from the soil will enter towards the total plant, such that the new plant will be developed. Fine, students, it is very easy. It is very easy process, grafting. So what is scion? The plant which you are going to keep on the rootstock is called as scion. Rootstock is nothing but which contains root which is present in the pot or the plant or in the soil is called as rootstock. And now you are going to cut the rootstock exactly with the same of scion, right? If you see the shapes should be exact similar, such that it should get inserted properly upon this rootstock. And it will be inserted finally, the scion will be inserted and it will be keep it will be kept upon the rootstock, and it will be binded tightly with raffia or tape, such that the new plant will be generated out from the mother plant. Fine. So this is about grafting, and the best examples of grafting are apples and avocado. And I forgot to say you the examples of layering. So the best examples of layering are boxwood and azalea. So I hope you would understand about natural vegetative propagation as well as the artificial vegetative propagation. And if you like my explanation, you can like this video, you can share this video to your friends, and you can subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates of my videos. Thank you.